actually just found out of this earlier today while I was practicing. So I'm pretty excited about. It would be kind of a swath of decks. The mid-range deck, the one Delver Mirror, one Bug Delver Mirror, and then two the Sneak and Show, and then one more like degenerate combo deck. I'm playing. I don't really have any outs for this. So we are just going to use this block. Yeah, we're just going to scoop it up here. Both teams played hard. Okay, so against this deck, I believe they have cantrips and we'll have Pyroblast. Because they don't use the graveyard, so I don't think I want Surgical. And I'm just going to cut my removal. Here, I can cut this. I could also probably shave the Trop. Maybe bring in like a little bit more interaction. Like, want to hit LEDs my opponent plays. Or maybe like hit a K command. But I guess I already have a bunch of threes, so maybe I don't want to do it. Forkbolt's fine, it might help swing a race. Or at least maybe they can learn to clear things out a little bit. Not a Forkbolt, but like, I don't think Surgical's. I guess you could Surgical like a Rite of Flame to slow your to mess my opponent's map out. Yeah, I'm gonna do alright, let's see if we can take a turn, take a game action. I can confidently say that I played that game perfectly. I think I'm going to ponder on one. I need to find like a threat, and hopefully I've got enough interaction here to stop my opponent from going off. My opponent from going off on turn one, not have the Stifle of Storm trigger. we're just gonna shuffle those. Alright, I mean, a second land's not that bad. If we're not gonna draw a creature. Here. I think I'm gonna force this. Yeah, I think I've gotta force this Sandy's one. I think I pitch. I kinda wanna keep the brainstorm. I think I'm gonna pitch. They can generate enough mana maybe to where the stifle doesn't matter. The Fluster Storm doesn't matter, but the stifle is always going to get rid of. It's always going to get rid of the storm triggers. So having lands. I'm more likely to bring an artifact removal for the second one, I think. I totally screwed the pooch here. Miscounted my mana. Yeah. I tossed this one. Just miscounted here. Which is just a complete like dumb move. Yeah, see now I definitely should have brought in my removal and I would have been able to counter that, but I could have stifled this activation. Yeah, that was stupid. I just tossed that game. Shaking off the rust. But that happens. I was just like completely zoned out. Not even thinking. And just tossed it. Maybe we'll win the rest of them. I'm gonna worry about it. This guy's got 22 trophies. This guy had like 10 trophies in the past like 3 or 4 days, I think. Maybe I'll go in. No Kalitos here? Okay, we'll do this. Probably gonna fetch a Vault with my first land. As much as I want to be able to cast Deathrite on it. I was gonna see that the coast is probably almost clear with a fair combo deck. It might just be like another Delver deck. Another combo deck. So we're off to the races. Counter this. If they know it can get countered, but like, what am I doing here? Saving this Spell Pierce for Force of Will Fodder, letting them groom, like, take their time. Like, maybe they need something. That's a great draw. What am I forcing? Show and tell. Flying Storm. But I'm not super sure. Man, last stream I had a week ago. I was busy. Shnikes. So I guess, how many points of burn do we have? We've got 1, 2, we have 11 points of burn. We're going to have discard. Pass fights. We are playing in storm. God, we are just not hitting to save our lives. That sucks. But at least we got this Forcible up, and we know two of our cards are dead. If I find a black source here, we're in the game. Jesus Christ. What a weird game. Like, I could sit here and hold these lightning bolts and just be bolting my opponent, but I don't actually think I'm going to win that game. Shuffled, okay. We found a land, can't win. Yeah, dude. Probably takes my force. Or they could take my ponder. Probably take my ponder. Maybe this daze will mess my opponent up. Like, is this daze better than a random draw? If they have Cabal Ritual, the daze gets them. I can ponder next turn. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna like take the daze. I think the daze is better than a random draw. Especially when I don't have another blue mana. And if they've got like, if it's Dark Ritual that starts them off, then so be it. Words on that. Okay, so they fit the pedal into Dark Ritual. F6. This storm counts 4. Both missed like effective land drops for so long in that game. I get these pyroblasts. I think that was added. This, now we're playing at nauseam tendrils, so the surgicals are decent. I cut all my little. I might bring some in on the draw for to play against Xanthan Swarm. Everybody's having a good night. Just sitting there and hanging out. It's already starting to get dark and gloomy. It's supposed to be summer. I guess it's 8 o'clock. I would like to play first. And I would like to keep. Now I'm just going to play Underground Sea Pass. And I'll Thought Scour. Or I could Brainstorm the Tuck. Probably stage this. Yeah, well, so I can hold the Flusterstorm plus Brainstorm, or plus Force of Will, which I think I'm gonna do. I wish gonna hold this. We'll play the Shaman next turn. Maybe we can go like Shaman Wasteland or Shaman. Then hold up a few more counter spells. We'll waste that. Alright, so now that we've got two of those, I think I'm pretty confident on the Shaman. Three double fours. Cluster Storm did, but I think I'll leave the Shaman down. I need to like start doing something. And it's a pretty weak brainstorm for my opponent. So they don't need the most value-oriented brainstorms to win. We have a pretty good turn next game with a brainstorm. Good brainstorm. Well, this is gonna name Force as well. So I've got to do Force Pitch. Cluster Storm. I think I need this brainstorm. Is another Cabal Therapy, and that's gonna suck. If my opponent goes for it though, I think I'm going to. And they must know that I have a Force, because I wouldn't have been that aggressive. That's a really good draw. So I'm gonna start by brainstorming. I'd like to find another threat. There's a threat, so. The question is, do I want to play it? I don't really want this brainstorm. I think once I get this angler down, I've got all I need to, all I want to win. So I'm actually just going to put brainstorm Gurmag back and hopefully not have to fetch. Because I've got counterspell plus, I have two counterspells. Next turn I'll untap and play the angler. Jam the angler, I guess, and then had. Well, I wouldn't have been able to have. I would have just had one counterspell. Could go bad for me. They have four cards in hand. Two of them are Cabal Rituals. But I think it's going to be hard with a Force and a Flusterstorm and a Death Rite to eat like an Infernal Tutor. I think it's going to be difficult. My top card's a Brainstorm. So I might not crack my fetch to have a blue card to go with this. Was a bait spell. It doesn't seem like it accomplished very much. What if my opponent was just trying to like get me to use one of my counter spells? I think I want the brainstorm. I'm gonna miss out. I missed out on 4 points of damage, which might matter, but we're opponent's on a 3-turn clock here. Now we're just gonna draw the brainstorm path and then crack them and pass. Probably brainstorm at the end of their turn, or if they play a cantrip. I get the Inferno Tutor, I think they're going to struggle to win. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, my gosh. Okay, I put another stop here. I usually have a stop there. I just took it off. I'm going to wait for them to start to go for it before I do this distraction. Ball. Here, I could surgical the Infernal Tutor to figure out if I need to force this or not, or just surgical the Infernal Tutor to see what's going on with my opponent. Oh, I'd love it if they were at 8. If they were at 8, they'd be just dead next turn. I think I'm going to surgical this to start. Need this to get going unless they had the tendrils in their hand. Which they did. They can go empty, but they don't have the mana. So, actually, they can go Cabal Ritual. They can go Cabal Ritual. Start with Darby. Okay, so we are dead here if our opponent names right. Okay with that because it's one less dude. So I block one, so I'm gonna attack. Block, attack. Oh yeah, I've got to attack really. So I'm just gonna have to start moving from the back. Yeah, this would be so much nicer if I hadn't clicked through my attack step there. Now I just want to drop this league and start another one. So I've like motored out of a game or two. If I fetch, there's 9 goblins. Fetch, I go to 8 and leave back 2 blockers. But I think I've got to start getting my opponent dead here. Flip Delver. Five. I think I'm gonna win this race. I have to not attack with my angler because there's 9 of these. So I just go block, block, take 7. All right. And I go 1. I have to make sure to activate my death bench on. Yeah, I'm just gonna let all this go here. Hopefully they don't find a way to like tendrils me. Out of this game. Then you do it with 2 cards, go bottom bottom. Hey, how's it going, Archmage? God, imagine if they found like a grape shot. How bad that would be here. Four. has been. I haven't been on for a week. I've been busy. Like, work has just been out of this world. Yes, you have a summer job. How is it? So do I want to bring in anything else? I don't really think so. I think I like all these cards here. Like, some of these cards are much worse than the draw. Like, maybe Trade Nemesis is just shenanigans. I should bring another fourth bowl. How is it? Johnny's on his way down. We're playing in the... I'm still waiting to do the whole code writing part. Nice. Johnny's on his way down. We're playing... this hand's great. We're playing in the team tournament. The Grand Prix in DC this weekend. Hopefully we don't get turn one. We're not getting turn one. I'm gonna stifle the shit out of my opponent. God, please crack your fetch land. My friend Tom, who we always play team tournaments with. God, crack your fetch land. Crack your fetch land. I'm gonna ponder. I don't think that there's anything. Like, I'm probably not gonna crack this. Probably just get in the days. Now I'm actually gonna draw this Delver, so I'm gonna go Spell Pierce, Days, Delver. I'm gonna play the Delver next turn. Yeah, I've seen the battle bot. I see there's like Trinity Nemesis in foil now. Which is kinda sweet. Cantrip or ritual or anything. I'll leave this wasteland. But we know our Delver's flipping. Now we will stifle this. Yeah. Well, most of the time that's kind of the case. Right? Because, like, they don't design with that in mind. So now I got double days up here. I could have just like nugged the deltas. Now we're gonna have, yeah, so we're pretty good. If they ditch anything that's important, we can just surgical it. Usually those secondary products do that. Like True Name Nemesis came in through the commander products at Nazim. So they don't have another copy of that, so there's no need for me to. Yeah, okay, reveal force. Rolling over. I mean, I guess more surgicals is probably alright. Yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna draw all these. Like, I don't think there's any way my opponent. And then I might just, like, draw a step, hit their surgicals. Yeah, I saw that one. Now I get, like, perfect information here. Maybe they drew a Delta. That would be kind of funny. What if they drew a Delta? Alright. I'm gonna go grab some water while this is on here. I should bring all these up. Here, hang on.
Yeah, I'm looking at him right now.
Whenever you cast a spell, untap target creature. I'm assuming you're talking about like a blue one, right? You're talking about Imperial Recruiter. I actually haven't seen that one.
Cantrips. I don't have a play until turn three. I have plenty of, but Daze is going to set me back. If it was a Delver, I'd keep it.
Yeah, I'll keep this hand. Put a bolt on the bottom.
Which I'm going to bolt on top. Do I have to force this? Yeah. The true name's good. Angler's gonna be good at. Well, Angler's probably not gonna be good. It's just gonna get chunk locked. That's something that I don't know. Like.
True name is only good if we stop natural.
Yeah.
Okay, so return an elf you control to our hand. Untap target creature.
This is annoying because this kind of like invalidates my removal.
Right, return an elf you control to its own hand. Untap target.
Yeah, I just killed this, but I have to find my removal first. I think I'm gonna brainstorm. I just kind of want to brainstorm. I'm not super comfortable with this elves matchup, so I don't really know how to attack it. I'm gonna brainstorm on my own turn to try to hit a land, make sure I hit a land drop next turn, because I don't want to have to brainstorm for a land drop and not be able to spell here so I can glimpse. We get a Valk. We're not very close to casting Angler. So I'm gonna shuffle back one of these. And it's probably the stifle. Yeah, I'm gonna shuffle these two back, draw the land. Why shouldn't we have fetched, right? Visionary, excuse me. Yep, get them beats on. Ooh. It's gonna cause him to. He's gonna bounce this Heritage Druid, but we still get to cast Gurmag Angler. Still just set him back. This guy's cradle isn't as effective as we thought. We might, and I could just force. I could force, like. I don't know. I guess I should be careful with my forces now. Like, now that we have Angler in play, I just need to make sure that I don't get, like. Like, we just have such a. We have a big beater. so they have. They got the druid in play. Here's druid, so this is going to tap for two. That means they just have natural orders. We punished if I had a Death Road Shaman there, but
I think I had so many good, I could have hit like Lightning Bolt, and I think that's the upside on Lightning Bolt's pretty high. And now I can at least force pitch the Stifle. It doesn't seem like Stifle is very good against this deck.
I still probably don't let like an Elvish Visionary resolve to stifle the trigger because it allows Heritage Druid to turn on. We gotta get rid of that. We could have just Hellscour and Pinch and not risk that double stun.
Yep, that was another good thing. I didn't think about that.
Yeah, it can't bounce itself. It's an insect, yeah. Okay, Lick on Mason Sage is good. There's still two elves. One elf away. Oh, you're talking about for this. Yeah, you're right. Now we're in a little bit of an unfortunate spot where I'm probably going to just cast my True Name Nemesis if I draw a land. I guess I could hold the True Name Nemesis and wait for another blue card. Oh, they can now because of this. Oh, you're right. Alright, we can't infinitely. So let me get in here first. And if they're infinitely jumping Angler, it's slowing their turn down, right? Oh yeah, because they just bounce. They're like elf, bounce, bounce. Yeah, I should have thought about that. But again, like I'm not very good at haven't played against elves that much. Yeah, the one day I agree, Archmage. We're getting this thing out of here. Now they have to sack. I don't know if they probably sack Reclamation Sage. They sacked Heritage Shred. All right, dude. I would love to flip my Delver to like a Lightning Bolt. Because then if I bolt something, it makes so they can't natural order me again. So now they're pumping the brakes. That's unfortunate. So I think I'm actually going to offer this trade. Here, I'm going to attack with both of my creatures, because if they just like trade one of these and they have to have a land or another creature in order to get Gaia's Cradle, they need a land for Gaia's Cradle to give them enough to let them natural order. So they just want to trade my Delver, they can trade my Delver. And if they start bouncing creatures, at least it's slowing them down. Yeah, so they're just going to take one. This makes it so that they need to go hit a land. Last three cards need to be land, net, and natural order, and then the Reclamation Sage in order to hoof me. There's the land. Oh, and there's the sage. This is probably going to get Dryad Arbor also. So we really need this Delver flip. Preferably to like a Lightning Bolt. Nope. Again, I'm just gonna save, do the same thing. I could have just attacked and then played another Deathrite Shaman, but I think it's worth think it's worth it to just activate the shaman and then hold this other one to make them at least think about what I could have. Though they know it's either a creature or a land. Because I didn't reveal, so that's no big news. We're already probably gonna get hoofed out of this. I guess we get hoofed 2-4. Yeah, they're slowly grinding back into it. If we flip our Delver, we kill him. There's their Death Wish on it. Okay. So let's hope our Delver flips. This game's gonna get much more annoying if our Delver doesn't flip. Because this Wirewood Symbiote's gonna be able to untap this Death Wish on it a million times. Because out of all Deathrite Shaman's, you know, weird quirks, it's also a relevant creature type. Let's flip. Come on. Yes. Get in there. So sideboard against this deck. Angler seems like garbage. Like, that guy's probably coming out. Though they bring in Abrupt Decays, but look what I want. I want a Braid, Forge Bolt. Yeah. I don't think I want Diabolic Edict. I don't really think I want Cake Man. I think I want these four cards. Cards I'm not super interested in. Stifle doesn't seem that great. Stifle just really stifles like the hoof trigger. And then these anglers don't seem that great either. So the game's gonna slow down after sideboarding. Maybe Cake Command's alright, and I can go something like this. Diabolic Edict seems kind of. Fletcher Storm's okay. Do you think Fletcher Storm's better than Gurmag Angler? Daze is meh. Yeah, I have so many like meh aspects of this on the draw. Like, these Diabolic Edicts, are these better than Dazes? Like, they kill something? You know? So maybe I should have one of these in here. Like, I could see a world where I go like this. Because, like, the Edicts at least kill something. Storm's really only good. I guess if we like, if they try to like kill me on curve, it's alright. Kill my neighbor. I think it's better than Fluster Storm, right? I actually need to make sure to pay attention. And maybe Fluster Storm's better than Diabolic Edict. Removal though. Like, it kills something. And they're kind of like a critical mass combo deck. Cause like there's only like eight creatures. There's only what matters in their deck to kill? Like Heritage Druid, Symbiote, and the rest of them all just kind of do the exact same thing. So they're just breaking up redundancy. And how many ways do I got? One, two. I only have two ways to answer. Yeah, I'm gonna bring these Fluster Storms in on the draw, which gives me like eight good answers to a quick glimpse of the unthinkable. Or is it glimpse of the unthinkable? I think I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna lead off on a Deathrite Shaman, and I've got a couple cantrips for turn two to find some interaction. Another Should I not just let him turn two glimpse me? Or do I ponder? I think I should have mulliganed. Yeah, I should have mulliganed. Now that I look back on it, Archmage, I should have mulliganed. This hand just doesn't do enough. I think I'm gonna play my own shaman and cross my fingers. Like, it's a good hand, like, it does stuff, but it's just kind of slow. But I'm only pondering for like four force levels, right? Metal Sentinel. This is like Heritage, the next Heritage Druids, right? God, you learn something new every day. Like this deck, oh wow. I did not think that this was gonna be this explosive. Yeah, that's part of this, like, I don't know some of this super, super well. Like, you know, my opponent obviously went nuts here, but they're also not doing anything. Like, they have a lot of live draws, but like, they just dumped their entire hand. Oh, this went from a Death Ray Shaman to this. Let's brainstorm. Oh, we need to kill the Scavenging Ooze. None of those cards kill Scavenging Ooze. They can make mana here and eat my graveyard, right? I'm getting tooled here. This is me, like, not paying attention, not knowing. At least next turn I can. Oh man, I can just K command this. That means they can attack with everything though. What a nut draw. Now all their stuff's too big. They can attack. You can attack with everything, right? Just target 1/1 gets +1/+1/2. Unless you want to just hold this back. Okay. Yeah, we're like up shit creek here. Alright, so Bolt at least lets us continue to play Magic. So I'm gonna do this first. Delver. I can just go double Delver, which is probably one of my. Well, no, because he's gonna death ride it. Maybe my opponent will get cute with their Delver of Secret with their death ride Shaman. I don't think I want this. And I don't think I want this death knight. So I'm get this back. I'm gonna shuffle here. And then I'll just wait. If they go to eat this, then I'll just thought scour in response. And then, like, I'll go K command, shoot this, make them discard a card at some point. Yeah, I'm learning things. Like, I'm just not super familiar with this Elves deck here, which is something that, you know, I'll learn from playing against it. Like, I just don't exactly know what's quite going on here. Because, like, there's just a lot of pieces here that I don't quite have going on here. It is cool how this is just, like, a big creature, you know, a big dumb creature deck that, you know, through, that just squeaks games out, you know what I mean? And, like, I don't play that much Legacy. I do like these Delver decks a lot, and they come naturally to me. What I don't understand, I don't really understand how to play against this deck. Like, I can play Nuts and Bolts Magic, but this deck just goes, like, over the top of me. Just because I don't know. Just two. I think it's on the stream decker. Alright, that's kind of annoying. So I'm gonna take two. I took this list from Dylan Donegan's deck. So I'm probably gonna take 4 or 5 here, go to lighting. He doesn't play Young Pyromancer. And I think he makes his deck, like, there's no Young Pyromancer. Shoot, that sucks. Okay, so play the Trinity Nemesis as defense. And then hope they miss for a turn, then command this. Yeah, I gotta go turn some more lights on. Lighting in my apartment's weird. This Delver back. Like, I'm okay. Well, the Delver doesn't do anything because they just kill the creature. Yeah, that was stupid. I'm just making all kinds of mistakes here. Alright, that's a good one. It's just music for the background, and it's non-copyright. That's literally the only reason. Hopefully they just play land. And then then this turn I will take him in. So I might have to kick him in now. I can't even play this. Shoot. Alright, we're gonna go here and here to get this off the battlefield. Probably. So I guess we're just gonna go like this. There's no other reason to do this. I do need to get the death right off the battlefield. I actually hit yes from early on the last health, which is stupid. Glimpse. Ooh, okay. We got a glimpse, which is good. So now, then next turn we're gonna play our own Deathrite, play our own Delver, and then hopefully, or if we just draw a land, we can go Liliana last open Delver, and then we can just start mowing down my opponent's graveyard, or mowing down my opponent's battlefield. Yes, that is much better. Block this, and then... I kinda just wanna soak up damage. This is 5, then I only take 3 of these trade. I actually need to, like, survive. Pump this, make this larger, but okay, so they're just gonna try to push damage, okay. If they have drawn death right, maybe I should have. Up here, block here, take 2. And then we have the Trop coming. So now that we have the Trop coming, we're going to be able to... I should have killed the Heritage Druid instead of that one. But I guess that makes it so another Abrupt Decay is not alive. And now we're just on full defense. What an odd game. Okay, Cradle for 1. 2, 3, 4. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Alright, so now we gotta get a move on. And we know our Delver's not flipping. So I think I'm gonna get in here with the True Name, and
I could just chump with the Delver. I could just chump this with Delver and then attack them for 8, gain 2 life. Do I limit draw steps? I think I'm gonna wait. I think I'm gonna wait and I'm just gonna ult this Liliana. And this Liliana is gonna win me the game. Because I can crack for 10 and then 10. So I'm 1 point off. Yeah, it is. It's an interesting game here. Because like I can hit for 10. Chomp. Then they make an elf, and the elf's lethal. Yeah, I think I just go conservative and hope that they've got to just miss on some more draw steps. As long as they don't natural order me, I should be okay. Land on oils, alright. Nah, I'm probably just gaining life, I think. We're in pretty good shape as long as I don't get run out of the gym by this. We'll reveal Ponder. Alright, let's start off by pondering. Should have pondered this one for that reason. So I can dismember this. I can waste this. I think I want to dismember this thing. So let's put this Delver into here. See, this is the mistake that I made. You'd have wasted the cradle. I guess that shuts him off from it, but then he makes mana. I just want to get this thing off the battlefield. I guess this actually turns on some things. You're right. No, you're right, because now he goes, make a dude. This comes back into play, draws a card. Cradle now taps for, he didn't make a guy. Why didn't he make a guy? Am I crazy there to wonder why he didn't make a creature? Oh, because he wanted to save his... No, but the elf still dies, even if he does this. Yeah, just die. He dies on his turn. Yeah, this isn't how this works. Yeah. And now they're back to having no more. They still can't natural order me. Next turn, waste this. Probably just roll down. So they get a dry hour now, where they're gonna abrupt case something. Choke. Spell pierce. The choke. And now it's game over. That's just gonna keep rolling up. Okay.
That's the chump. It's 11 on the dot. Yeah. Alrighty. So I think there's different ways that I could have played that. Like what you were talking about, Archmage. Friend just posted a picture, and his download speed is 458 megabytes per second, and his upload's 24. Holy shit. That's unreal. Yeah, I didn't play perfectly that match because I just didn't really know. That's a matchup that I'm not comfortable with. Like, I'm fairly comfortable with these Delver mirrors because, like, it's magic, you know? I'm not comfortable playing against elves because, like, I don't really understand what's happening. It's just confusing. Be right back. Philly boy. Dude, Archmage, Philly's getting so big. I took Philly to the, come here, Phil. Phil. Come here, buddy. Philly boy. I took Philly, sit buddy, look at him. I took him to the hospital, I took him to the vet yesterday, weighs 46 pounds. Like our little pup is growing up. I would like to play first. Got a mulligan this. Had rough sevens, I got a mulligan this too. Though this hand is like, no, it's still not good. Dude, he's huge. Keep this, put that on the bottom. Deathrite Shaman. Because then if we hit a land, we can probably play like a True Name Nemesis. And then, or if they play a fetch land, like we can maybe steal this game. Yeah, he's so big. So hopefully we draw a land and like this True Name Nemesis matters, though it probably doesn't matter against basic island. Like, just hopefully there's a world where this Nemesis is important. And it just... because this card can steal games. I thought about playing three of these. Like, maybe... like, just one more on the board. Like, I kind of want one more grindy card. Okay, well, let's start by pondering. That forest seems really important. Then we're going to stack it like this. Draw the force... oh, I should have... well, I need the land in order to cast. So I did it... I think I should have made it so I could... like, my Delver's not flipping now. But... but if I draw... like, if I get to play True Name next turn, if that matters. But I determine it's a combo deck, then I probably will just hold it for Force of Will. Yeah, I probably could have stacked that better. I probably could have stacked, like, a land underneath, like... and just missed my land drop for a while. Yeah, I think I could have stacked that differently. That's the fun part of this deck. There's so much going on. And it's so difficult to play. Alright, nice. So it looks like this True Name Nemesis is probably going to be okay. Unless my opponent's going to miracles. Which, if they're miracles, I think I'm not going to... I think I'm going to put my opponent on miracles. I can't remember my bottom card. My bottom card is a lightning bolt, I think. Yeah, I think my bottom card is a bolt. Miracle. now we have, like, we have quite a bit of reach. Though we're probably just going to determine this. Maybe they want to land a Jace and they don't want me to bolt it. Get that shit out of here. One time.
No.
Well, now they are. This is interesting because they know they can't. They can't. Like, if they. Yeah, bounce them down. This seems like an adult decision. I feel like we're in this game. Assume that they don't have a lot going on, because that was just like a pretty weak. Unless they have another Jace, which they might have. That just seems like a pretty weak, like a pretty weak set of players. Spring Verdict versus another Jace. So whatever they do here. I don't really want to commit another Delver. I don't really want to trade my Delver with a Snapcaster. I just want to Terminus. Take this Brainstorm. Yeah, I probably should take Ponder. Mm-hmm. And now we get buried. Now Jace gets us. I don't think they have any main deck red cards. It's just Pyroblast on the side, which probably means that they don't have back to basics, which is nice. Playing Valk in your mana base makes back to basics seem kind of greedy. Brainstorm away, brainstorm your heart desires. If they deal with this Delver, we're gonna you know, yield. Come on, Delver. Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna see if this resolves. If this resolves, I'm gonna attack Jace. If it doesn't resolve, I'm gonna attack my opponent. Okay. Though I could just attack. I think I'm just going to attack my opponent. then hope they get, like, comfortable and I can find a way to maneuver this lightning bolt. Like, they can just bounce my Delver, but at least they're not brainstorming. So they drew Portman. I probably should have... I don't think it's right to just ignore a planeswalker and go after your opponent. But I also don't really have a lot going on here. I actually think now's a good time to bolt my opponent. Because they don't know what this next card is. Scour, we can return a creature. Because we dig tick down with Liliana. I have to cut a card. Oh, just another lightning bolt. Leaves me a little in trouble to Monastery Mentor. Hey, how's it going? How's it going there, Tyler? I'm gonna try this. How are you, Delver? Swole Nation, yeah. I just beat Elves there. I just beat Elves there, Tyler. Would not be proud of how I played. I had my head squarely up my ass. Part of it was just not knowing. Part of it was I didn't know what cards were good when. Okay, you're cloudless. I didn't know Ponder into a Shaman. Yeah, I just didn't really know what was going on, and I didn't know, how good some of the creatures were. I didn't know Bursler Ranger made mana of a different color, you know? What do we got here? Alright. Sure. Slow trip. I really want to get this Angler down. A little nasty, Gurmasty. protect it with his force. Draw a card. Always my skills, yeah. Just a filth. This fifth heritage druid. Land, because now I can't play Angler unless I give up my white spells. Unless I want to go something like this. Shuffle this back. And then I just draw the Daze next turn, which Daze is probably going to be fine at some point in this game. So I actually might as well just put back the Flusterstorm. 1, 2, 3, 4. No, I don't have enough mana. God, I muffed this all up. Unless we just don't care about red spells. Which, how many red spells that matter? Just like the Pyroblasts? Yeah, I think we're going to get the Angler down. So let's go like this. Fetch for another Underground Sea. And then let's just get nasty. With Gurmasty. Hopefully we can just ride Gurmy all the way. Gurmy just takes us to the promised land. That's nice. Which one, what card do I pitch? Flusterstorm or Daze? I think I'm gonna pitch Flusterstorm. Take that. I probably should have counted back because it puts up. Yeah, we go. I was thinking about like a Jinx, you know? Like that brainstorm was super telegraphed. Wow, the second draw. Like that brainstorm was so weak that it just says like this guy is just has putting a terminus on that. Yep, that was my mom. She's telling me she's back from Barcelona. So that's weird. They had a pause in their draw stat, which means they had a miracle trigger, they just didn't do it. Well, now I can pitch this Delver to this force. And then have Daze also. Treat the angels. So I'm actually going to float a blue mana and return this underground seed in my hand because I want to force this. Force pitch predict. Okay. Now I'm just going to force pitch Delver. And I did that because if I drew a brainstorm, I wanted to have one more card in my hand in order to make it so like the brainstorm was better. They don't have anything. Yeah, I guess they always do. Which I guess is good. It doesn't give anything away. This is a Jace. That's pretty verdict, okay. Alright, give me a fetch land. Alright, that's not bad. So we have a little bit of reach. Jeez. All right. I'm gonna just double stone raise me. At least we have a land in our hand. Yes. It's not there. All right. Let's play this land now. From the ashes. So that's what part of the red splash is. Crack that. Alright, so this is pretty good. You have one turn, my friend, and if their card is force, we have that covered. Don't have a plow. Don't have a plow. Okay. One time. But, I mean, they're at two, so if we do get to this K command, which is going to be difficult, especially considering how we sideboarded. So I have to make sure I remember to pay mana for my days here, so I don't bounce a land back to my hand. Just my cute little Delver. We might do it. We might be okay. Okay, can't counter that. Come on, land. Alright. So we're actually good here. Unless they have force, pitch. Another two, but let's hope. Oh, they have it. Oh, that's so gross. So maybe I'm supposed to just wait, but I don't know. It doesn't feel like it's ever getting any better for me. So what do you got left on our deck? We've got two lightning bolts. We have one lightning bolt. Oh, that was gross. At least they don't have, like... Okay, so there's a Delver, so let's play this Delver. Don't show me a one. Okay, they're drawing a land. Stop that. I tap them out, but it doesn't matter. So now they mill their flooded strand, they draw two cards. Then hopefully they just go brick, brick, and our Delver flips. Yes. Let me draw the force. Oh wow, they're gonna let me draw the force. Come on. Oh. Alright, I'm actually going to restart Modo after I re-sideboard here. So let me think. On the draw, I probably can cut like one less days and have another bolt in my deck. That was very fortunate. Probably use something like this. Like, Daze loses its allure pretty, or loses its pretty quickly, but they're like a much more clunkier big deck. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go like this, and then I'm just going to restart Modo as soon as the game starts. I think that's the plan. Good, I'm going to keep it. Now let me just close out. Let me move you guys over to here. Sorry about this, but I guess while we're doing this, my name's Dylan Hovey. I'm part of the Cardboard Network. Here, you guys want to run on my stream. If you guys haven't seen, please hit the follow button. If you want to support me anymore, you should go to my YouTube page and subscribe to that. All my streams are archived on YouTube and it's free. Gamer Craze's Crystal Commerce, click below. That's a store that I learned to play Magic at. So you should check them out. And Card Hoarder is the best bot chain in the business. So if you guys have any Magic Online needs, you should check them out. Now we're just going to restart Modo. And then hopefully we win this last game. We play for the 4-1. This is part of the reason why I want to like figure this deck out. Is because like while I'm not a super great pilot, the whole Delver strategy comes natural to me. You know, I play Death Shadow, I like aggressive decks that play kind of tempo-oriented Magic. We are loading up here soon. I like the deck, the style of the deck comes naturally to me. I've only played Delver in like, okay. I've only played Delver in two or three large events. And I top 64 an SCG Classic, or an SCG Open, playing Delver, and it was the first time that I had ever played Brainstorm in a Legacy tournament, and I top 8 a Classic. So, the type of Magic resonates with me. So, I do like the type of the games it creates. What I need to become is just a little more knowledgeable about the format. If I were to become knowledgeable about the format, you know, the combo with the deck, because the deck's just great. Like, I'm not necessarily playing super optimally, but still doing very well, and that's just because of the quality of the deck. I probably should have led on my trial. Because that could give me the option to brainstorm. Oh god, I clicked the wrong card. Oh my god, I clicked the wrong card. I was like watching, I just reset something on my stream, and I was like watching that out of the corner of my eye while playing. Alright, let's make the best of it. Alright, I'll be okay. Not ideal, but it'll be okay. That happens sometimes when you stream, like you just accidentally hit the wrong button. So now at least we're gonna be able to waste this ball. So let's hit this. If they float mana, we'll... I guess I'm actually not going to. I'm going to play my Deathrite Shaman now because if they go to counterspell it, I can daze. I guess they would have done this anyways, but I'm going to win these. Because I would have gone to pass priority. They would have played their Deathrite Shaman. They would have gone predict. If we go pass priority, they would use their mana. I would have floated black, dazed, and then played Deathrite Shaman. That's another thing that's difficult about this deck that I'm used to, like when I stream, because I played so much Death Shadow that I can basically play, I can basically stream Death Shadow while being on autopilot, and it's a little more difficult to do that with a deck that I'm not super familiar with. So 1, 2, 3, if I find... They're gonna Terminus my Deathrite Shaman. I think I'm alright with this. I think we're just gonna let this go here. Like it's a weak, I don't really want to brainstorm here because that feels kind of weak. I think I'm just gonna play my Underground Sea and Ponder. So let's go like this. Something that I find is like a little odd with this deck is that there are so many people that tell me that as an Delver player you should. Hey, how's it going, Johnny? As a Delver player in a lot of these matchups, you should board out your forces. And like, while a lot of the times I do like trimming some forces, I find that, like, because my opponent's spells are such more higher quality than mine are, I need to be able to force through some of mine. So I can again forgo red mana in order to go, like, Delver, or I'm gonna play Deathrite Shaman and Angler. So I think I'm gonna do that. Then I can play the Trunade next turn. So let's get this in here. Underground City. We're gonna get nasty. And play the Shaman. They've already used one Terminus. And I'm definitely gonna force a Terminus. My opponent. Because I'll probably force a Jace. I'm gonna force it back, they pitch a brainstorm. They're gonna get two of my creatures, and then I'm just gonna play this tree and says I have a ponder. No, I fetch, I don't have a ponder coming. That's a good one to follow up with. They're two Terminus down. So this True Name should be able to do some work. But this one would help. Because it's just like a slam of the counter judgment from the most bottom. Back to basics. Just read. Yeah. Okay. That's both not what we want here. Okay. So both kind of on empty here. My opponent's deck obviously operates better at this stage of the game than mine does. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I should have done that, because now I get like wrecked by From the Ashes even more. I'm just going to try to keep my graveyard intact as much as possible. Keep that Druid in there. So that if I drop my K Command or my Last Hope, I can bring it back. Really tight game. I am running out of time. So you don't have like a Swords to Plowshares, so I'm free to just like eat anything here. They could go like Plow, Snap, Plow, and it'll, you know, but like there's just things that we're not beating. The Brainstorm blocks. So, I'm trying to eat this verdict. Alright, we'll keep that in our hand. Cover when I'm coming from the ashes. Us, we only have one more black source in our deck, so that's going to be important. And then my opponent is on a two-turn clock. Staticaster. Okay. And that's because he thinks we have Pyromancer, but we don't, which is nice. I mean, this is kind of effectively a dead card. So now I'm going to eat the Ponder. Because I don't want to eat an instant and then have my opponent be able to snap it back and knock the damage in. Oh, we hit our Liliana. That was so good. I'm going to hold this Shaman, or hold this Delver. Because there's no need of overextending into Terminus. My opponent's still dead next turn, because I have to go like block this, probably. I eat. If they don't deal with this Gurmag, then we get him. I guess we don't necessarily get him, but. Again, just take a sorcery. So I make sure to get the damage in. Seats. All right, let's play for the 4-1. How's my volume doing for everybody that's watching? I'm gonna go get some water. Johnny, you guys must be getting close. I do like this deck. I think I need one more grindy element. Maybe one more K Command or one more Liliana Lasso. So I've been really impressed with this card. No, I don't want Snapcaster Mage in a deck like this. I want Snapcaster Mage in a deck that has Cabal Therapy in it. Like, I've been thinking about adding a Snapcaster Mage to my other Grixis Delver. Like maybe, not in Stifle, but in regular Grixis Delver, maybe like finding another room for another card, like a Kolaghan's Command or a Last Hope or a Snapcaster Mage. That's what I think. But there's a lot to it. Let's hurry up and get paired. After this, I'm going to jump in to another league. If I 4-1 with this deck, I'll be
12-3 with it today, which is nice. I do like, I'm a big fan of this deck. How's the chat doing today? You must be getting close, Johnny. Well, how long? You guys like, what, an hour out? Half an hour out? Something like that? Let me see if I missed anybody here. No follows tonight. You guys are killing me. You guys are killing me. I'm at 857, so I'm trying to get up to 1,000, because then I can get, excuse me, I can apply for other subscriptions through other bot chains, so that maybe I can, like, sell my Magic collection and then just, like, get cards through bot chains. And I could, like, play for free in more big tournaments, you know? Hand's great. It's pretty soft. This is a hand where I might force a Death Rate Shaman. My opponent shamans me, I might just force it. Because, like, they're gonna have shaman superiority on me. Okay, that's nice. We're gonna be able to play our shamans. So we're playing against Miracles again. More long, drawn-out Magic. Can you shuffle with this? It did shuffle. Okay, so it's just Ponder, but it's slow. Draw a card. That's going to be great for next turn. Probably gonna daze whatever my opponent does here. Just to keep the tempo. Is a Searchlight Kanto? Is a Path to Exile. Okay. I don't think that one's worth fighting over. I would fight over. I think I'm gonna fight over the Germ. Like, we're gonna set up a fight for the Germ Angler. Path to Exile. Opponent metagaming or what? That's not good. I'm actually just gonna get rid of. I guess the Wasteland's better than. Because they're not gonna Wasteland me, and I don't need double black. So yeah, let's just go like this. Play this thing, pass. This is probably gonna be a Vault. Hopefully we can start interacting. Because, like, I'd like to fill my graveyard. I could have forced, I guess, that Path to Exile. Just fetching my upkeep. You know, draw something sweet like a Stifle or creature Death Rate Shaman is also very sweet. I'm gonna play this so that I can, like, spell pierce. And then maybe, like, pay mana for days. Force my Death Rate Shaman. I kind of want to force back, pitch a daze, and then I can daze like a Jace,
Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. And then my angler, like, I think we're just gonna force pitch this. Keep this shaman in play. Like, if they're willing to fight over it that bad, I think I'm going to as well. I might be aggressive knowing that I've got this angler back here, but like, the more stuff, the better. I'd like another black source. This is their own Jace. What's his judgment? Okay. Well, now we're just... After them using the council's judgment. Hopefully they just draw the Jace here. They slam the Jace and then I can daze it. If I ever get to use this daze, I'll be excited. I wonder if they're like a true name, they're a true name deck or they're, no, they're definitely a Miracles deck. They play Dwarven. Okay. Stifle's not bad, kind of harasses their mana. Just anything that anything that's like disruptive. Anything at this point, I'll take. I'm not gonna play my angler because he taps me out. And this card's like enough pressure on its own. I can stifle a miracle trigger, so maybe I'm actually just gonna wait on that then. Because I can stifle a miracle. I'm not gonna fight over land number 5. I will stifle this trigger. So my opponent's running on empty. Okay. So we're gonna go like this. Because I have another True Name coming, I'm going to jam this Gurmag Angler. Well, I guess wait 1 second. So if I play, this is 3, next turn is 5, 2, 1. It shaves a turn off the clock, right? Because they go block, go to 5, and then they die. It could potentially, like... Could potentially go a little haywire, but because we're committing another creature, if they like top deck a Terminus, this kind of sucks. But we have another True Name coming. Okay. Mentor's a good draw. I'll try to find a Lightning Bolt. Now the question is, do I jam True Name, give them one draw step? And I think I'm going to. You get one draw step, buddy. No miracle. Fluster Storms, the Kolaghan's Command, the Pyroblast, the Last Hope, Cut, Dismember, like One Days, Fork Bolt, Lightning Bolt, and then like 2 Wastelands. Because Wastelands not great against them. They're not going to mess with our mana base. And then Submit. Then after this, we're gonna run it back with a new Delver deck. I think I'm gonna keep this just because I don't want a mulligan. I don't want a mulligan in a resource efficient matchup. It's not like this hand's god awful. I have a, I have threats, I have cantrip, I have counterspell. This card's pretty good in the matchup. One reason I don't want to play Snapcaster is because I don't want it to get, I don't want to have like a major 2-for-1 card be open to get pyroblasted. Then next turn I'm just gonna brainstorm into another Delver. We're gonna play a more conventional Delver deck after this league here for one more tonight. Flip, come on Delver. Nice. That's not even a bad card to flip it to because the, because like pitching a force to a force isn't that bad. Play out another Delver. I've got pretty much everything but Supreme Verdict covered. Shuffle that away. Maybe I should have just left that, not worried about it. Let's return this. Okay, so they're drawing an Aerith Mesa. Don't Supreme Verdict me. Is okay. Top, top, top. No shuffle. There's the air mix that we knew about. So I think I'm actually just going to crack this fetch land and brainstorm. Here to their top card. I would assume it's a Terminus. Plow. Okay. So if I get in here. I'm going to pitch my other force. Force restore. Okay. Okay, so my force gets countered. One of my elders dies. I crack them. And then I
two, three, play an angler. Does not use counterbalance ability. And then they're still dead on board next turn. They need something. I know it's the top card. Hopefully it's not going to get us here. Hopefully they didn't just like super set us up. Get a lot of looks. We don't have a lot. I mean, we have another Delver, which is good. And we've got two bolts left in the deck and a K command for reach. So we have some reach. But it's definitely tight. Tight game. If the opponent's tanking this hard, then it's probably good. We're just concede. Alright, so we ended with the 4-1. Alright. So what do I think about this deck here? I like this deck a lot. I like this version of it. It's low to the ground. Stifle gives it a whole other angle of attack. I'm very interested in this list. I'd like one more grindy aspect. Maybe one more kick command or one more last hope. But I do like this deck here. So,